You might want the quarterback. You might want linemen. So, you know, have your ducks in a row. Have your starting five. We're playing games because that's what they do with us anyways. Oh, this ain't gonna work, honey. I need to turn on my ear. It's hot. Hey, y'all, welcome back to my channel. Better than your favorite bad bitch. Turned the whole world into a savage. Middle finger and all of my bitches just to remind y'all I ain't having it. As you can see, I'm in my car. And this is my first video in my car. And I'm feeling kind of good about it. Yeah. But anyway, today I wanted to film a... Oh my God, it's so hot in here. It is 95 degrees in this car. It's like 80 outside. Anyway, today I wanted to film a freshman advice video for incoming freshmen. Because I'm a sophomore now. And I feel like I have some good advice for the peoples. Basically, I wrote down some stuff that I want to talk about. And then the rest of the stuff is just going to be on top of it. The rest of the stuff is just going to be off the top of my head. We'll see how long this video takes. Let's sit back and get comfortable. All right, so we're going to try to make this quick because the sun is beaming. And I try to turn the air on, but I don't want y'all to not hear me. So we're going to try to compromise here. One of the first things I wanted to say is when y'all watch all those hauls, there's a lot of stuff in there that you won't need. Especially if you're going to IU because a lot of it is just provided and available on campus. At least it was for me. So I wouldn't say worry about a couple of things. Of course you can come prepared. It's never wrong to come prepared. But if you're on a budget and if you're, you know, deciding between this or that, you know, get what you think is the most needed and then kind of cruise. So basically what I was trying to say with that is there's a couple of necessities that you need to have, like a comforter, a sheet. There's a couple of school supplies that you need, like obviously notebooks, pencils, stuff like that. But I wouldn't say buy anything in excess because some stuff you just won't use and then it'll just be like pointless. If you don't know what your room looks like, don't go and buy a whole bunch of storage areas when you might have a built-in closet that's, you know, a walk-in closet, not huge closet, but you know, like a closet that actually has a door, and then you won't even need that storage that you bought or whatever. So try to do the bare minimum and then kind of get what you need as you go, because I have a lot of stuff, or kind of a lot of stuff that I just didn't use that I bought for no reason. So there you go. So you don't have to come with, you know, everything that you see on YouTube everybody got. It's really not that deep. You'll be okay. Just go to school and pass your classes. Another thing is a very important one, when you get there and you make friends and stuff like that, you don't have to go to every party. Somebody has to say it. I'm sorry, somebody has to say it, because there will be so many people and so many influences on you to go to parties every weekend or go to Darty's or go to whatever. And of course I go to a party school, so I would know these things, but I just feel like it's probably a college thing in general. People want to party, and you have to remember that you're in college for school and not for parties. So it's okay to go to, you know, a couple or some here and there, or some every other weekend. Every weekend is a no. Every weekend is a no. Unless you have all your stuff done, all your stuff, whatever. And even then, it just depends. It just depends, you know. 21 plus, do what you want. But as freshmen, you're there for school and to have a good time sometimes, okay? Not too crazy. Next thing I want to touch base on is something that I struggled with myself and could not get it figured out for the life of me. Or at least I couldn't figure out how to solve the problem that I was having. So basically, you need to have a routine, okay? You need to have a routine in general, because when you're in high school and when you're in middle school and when you're in elementary school, they give you a routine. You wake up at 6 in the morning, you get on the bus at 7, you go to class, you eat lunch at 12, you go back to class, you get out of school at 3, whatever. They put you on a schedule, so you're used to schedules because you've been doing it your whole life. When you're in college, the only schedule that you're on is when your classes are. So the only time that you actually have to do anything is go to class. And you don't even have to do that because they don't make you do that. So really, the freedom is up here. You have to be able to create your own schedule that you're going to stick to, and a routine that you're going to stick to, so that you don't feel like you're not doing enough And so that you're not, like, doing too much to where you just feel like you're working all the time or, like, you're overexhausted, whatever, doing too much. The point is to have a schedule and a routine that you're going to stick to, that is healthy and well-balanced. Get a routine, stick to it. You'll be happy that you created the routine and that you're sticking to it. That's something to be happy about. There you go. So the next thing is reaching out for help with anything. Basically, this is your home away from home. You have to make it worthwhile, and you have to make it so that you feel like you're at home and not, like, away and stranded and whatever else. I would say for any problems, reach out for help, because there's people specifically there to help those specific problems. There's different departments for everything. So if you feel like, oh, I need a tutor, find a tutor because there's one there. You don't like your schedule, you want to drop a class, you want to change your major because you don't know what you're doing anymore, you had a reality check and you're like, I don't want this. Advisors, there to help you. Anything else, literally, SAD, there's people for that, there's therapists, there's all type of stuff. So I wouldn't say suffer in silence ever, because nobody there wants you to do bad, basically. They're getting paid the big bucks to help you. So I would say, you know, go get some help if you need it. Like, that's what they're there for. Another thing is rate my professor. I don't know if y'all know about that. I don't even know how I found out about it, but before second semester, because first semester they created our schedules for us. We just kind of chose what classes we were gonna be in, but we didn't know anything about the professor, so we kind of just got thrown in. But second semester, when I was creating my schedule, I would look on Rate My Professor and look at all the teachers' ratings and everything and make sure, you know, they're not crazy or whatever. And also get recommendations for people that you know took the class. See if they like their teachers, see if they don't like them. If they're like, don't take that professor, then don't take that professor, because it really matters. The professors matter, because most of them are old and don't care about anything. They're just there for a check. So make sure you have a good one. And I use it for everything now. It literally, it's every school. So definitely use that. Another thing I was gonna say is to get involved in something that's outside of just academics. Do something, you know, like extracurricular. It's good for your resume, and it's also good for you, so that you don't feel like you're just at home. I mean, you're just at school for school. It's kind of like more than that, especially if you don't have friends that you already know there and you're just kind of like alone. A great way to find new people to talk to and new people to meet and things like that, join a club, join an organization, join something to where you're in the same boat with other people. Wait, I didn't join a club, or did I? I don't know. I was trying to do a lot of stuff, but I was the floor representative for my floor in the dorm that I lived in, and then I applied to be an RA, and I'm gonna be an RA this fall, so, or this year. That is a job in itself, but it's something I got involved in. So do stuff that you can do outside of school, so that you're not only doing Zooms and going to class and only doing schoolwork and only studying. Find something that, you know, more chill, more laid back. Now, this advice is for my ladies. As an incoming freshman, I know there's a lot of stigmas around the football players, the jocks, the boys who are in frats, all that type of stuff. Babe, it's risky. Just know it's risky, okay? I would not recommend, or I would not advise, talking to the first boy that you meet. It's good to have friends. Keep them as friends for as long as you can, because you might like his friend, you know? So I wouldn't say just go for the first person that tries to talk to you, or just go for, you know, the first one that you meet, because you need to meet the whole team. You need to meet the whole friend group. You need to meet the whole everything. Meet all the frats. Meet all the frat brothers and whatnot, you know? Don't just talk to the one cute that you see. Don't just talk to the one football playing wide receiver that you see, okay? You might want the quarterback. You might want a lineman. So, you know, have your ducks in a row. Have your starting five. We're playing games, because that's what they do with us anyways, okay? The stigma around football players in college is that they're players. And definitely don't get emotionally attached to them, because this isn't going past this semester, love. Like, we're not even talking about a boo for the year. We're talking about a boo for a couple weeks, a couple parties. Nothing crazy. Nobody's getting in life long-term relationships with these men. Especially if you're a freshman and you're talking to a senior or talking to a junior. Pack it up. Keep them as friends. Play your little game if you want to, but yes, because they're good as friends. I would just say keep them as friends. That's the safest route to go. This next tip is for people with roommates. As a freshman, you're gonna probably get placed in a, I'm only speaking for IU, I don't know, but as a freshman, we got placed in like random dorms. We couldn't pick exactly where we was at, but you can pick a learning center, or a living learning center, but I didn't have a preference. So I got put in Collins. If anybody knows what that is, it's not like one of the best dorms. It's really not, but it was convenient for me, and I made it fun because I had a big room. And also I knew my roommate, like I got to choose who my roommate was. So if you know somebody that's going to your school, you want to room with them, definitely do that, because stranger just doesn't sit right with me. So I didn't want to do that. But if you do get a stranger, I would say number one, have boundaries, because I would say me and Kenzie had boundaries, and I realized that a lot of people don't have those, and that they are friends and they're cool and everything, and so they just go in each other's closets and I'm gonna borrow this shirt and I'm gonna borrow your shoes and it's fine, it's cool, I'm not gonna ask anymore, I'll just do what I want, I'll sleep in your bed sometimes, it's okay. Absolutely not. Have boundaries, because that might be cool one day, but that don't mean nothing. We low-key about to finish this video down here because all of my devices keep overheating. The ghetto. 94 in the car now, just for an update. But either way, back to what I was saying. The boundaries with the roommates. That is very essential, because I would hate... I just feel like people get into it about that and like they will fall out and they were friends when they first started and now they're not even friends anymore just because there was no communication involved. There was no... boundaries, and we need those. Yeah, I feel like this is such a weird angle. Hey, that's that on that. I can't think of nothing else. I kind of just winged a lot of stuff, and I wasn't really focused on, I was focused a lot on my schooling and trying not to have breakdowns, because when you're on a scholarship, you don't want to waste money by changing your major a million times and like not doing the right thing, and then it makes you be in school longer. So I was trying to avoid all ills possible, basically. Like, yeah, so I would say definitely have your head on straight, which is like hard to do when you get involved with all the people that literally party every weekend. I need you to stay with the right crowd, seriously, because a lot of people get lost in the sauce. And it's okay to have fun. Literally, it's fine. That's what you're in college for. Nobody just wants to go to school to just go to school. We've had enough of that. We've been doing it our whole lives. But it's the way that people are coming out of their pocket for tuition and stuff like that. And you earned your scholarships and everything. So why not get a degree out of it? Why? You're not just going there for fun 24/7. You still have things to do. You're gonna have bills to pay when you're done. So let's, focus on the bigger picture here and not just a couple weekends of fun and then get kicked out because you can't pass your classes. That was a little deep. I don't wanna scare anybody, but I would say stay on your stuff, because it's really like, it's all fun and games sometimes, but then when it's finals week, you have to pass your classes. So when it's midterms, you have to pass your classes. When it's test exam day, have to pass your exams. Like, everything else is fun though. Like, I had a lot of fun this year, a lot of fun, but I also did good in school. So another thing I would say, don't be scared to communicate with your professors, because 9 times out of 10 they're either really nice, that's like 30%. The other 70 is they're like rude and old and don't know anything about anything. But that's the whole point. If something's wrong with your grade, if something's wrong with how the class is set up and the teacher missed it, whatever, you need to tell them, because in the end, that will only affect you. Because a lot of teachers, or if a lot of people don't reach out, I know the class of 2021 and class of 2020 and all of us, our generation these days, we gonna talk, okay? We gonna tell them what the problem is and not care. We're gonna, We good with all the bombarding, and we good with all the coming with people with facts. Okay, I know that we good at that. So, in the group chats and stuff, everybody would like, let's all email him about this. If it's enough of us, he's gonna listen. And that's true. So, group me. I just forgot about group me that fast. That's basically what everybody uses in college. That's like a whole new wave of social media. That's your iMessage. You can create group chats for each class that you're in. Make sure to join it, because there will be one for every class that you're in, especially if the class is like math, or the class is like anatomy, or the class is a class with like 200 people in it. You're gonna have group me for it, so that all of y'all can like communicate with each other, help each other out, stuff like that. Don't just walk into the class. You already don't know anybody, so don't not meet anybody either. If you need help, you need to type in the group me and ask somebody, do they know the answer? Because why would you suffer alone and there's 200 other people in your class? Like, there's no reason. There are some people that will, you know, be kind of know-it-alls and won't ever try to help nobody, but there are a lot of people who will help, because at the end of the day, it's a grade and we all trying to pass. Like, we're all just trying to pass. Also, with the creating your schedule and your routine, I would say, let's not procrastinate. That having a routine and having a plan and a schedule helps you not procrastinate. If you're writing out your days every day, what you're gonna do this day, the next day, the week, you can't procrastinate, because you know that you have these things to do. And you're going to do them because you wrote them down and you said that you was going to do them. So, it helps you be more responsible and help you, like, not procrastinate. Because when you write out your days, you know what you're doing at every hour of the day. Then you know, oh, I got the weekend off because I did work Monday through Friday. You know, I'm good. Yeah. And so you don't have to, like, remember everything off the top of your head, because that's just not a good habit. I would say write everything down. I use my iPad to write everything down. I have a to-do list of things that I need to do. I would show y'all, because it's so long. It might look unorganized to y'all, but I literally just wrote it out. I know some people are more, like, organized with it. Like, they have times, and they have days, and they have homework section, and they have a non-school related section where they do this. Whatever, however they work it out. I just write all my stuff that I have to do in one day. It doesn't matter the order or whatever. I try to write it in, like, from morning to night, but if I don't do it in that order, it's fine. Just whatever comes up first, like, priority is like the first things that I think of, so I write it down. But basically, have a list of stuff that you need to do, a schedule, a to-do list, if you will, because you do not need to be trying to remember everything off the top of your head, because that ain't gonna work. One more thing, because I just keep thinking of stuff. This video is, like, very crazy. It's kind of, like, everywhere. But the point is, get comfortable with meeting new people, because you will need connections. Connections are very important in college. You meet a lot of people from a lot of different walks of life. And they can be used for different things. I'm not saying meet people to use them. But people might come in handy if you know them and you're cool with them and, you know, you just might so need a ride to a party, and, like, you met that last person at that last party, and you know that they're going to this one. You might say, can you give me a ride this time? Just something as simple as that. You can use them for, like, help some, whatever. As freshmen, you probably don't have a car, so having connections is serious if you, because nobody's trying to Uber to every party. You have to know people to, you know, get to where you're going and get to the functions and everything. So, also, when you do meet those football players and those frat boys and things like that, get friends with them, you know, especially if they're juniors and sophomores with apartments and stuff like that. You'll find yourself at a darty. You'll find yourself at a darty with your friends, okay? Living it up. I would definitely suggest doing that, because it was a good time for me. College is about having a good time, okay? Just a good time. Nothing crazy, nothing wild, maybe. Depends on how you are, but why not? You know? So that was a good time. And that's why I say be friends with people, get connections, get people that have cars, people that have apartments, people that, you know, all types of different people. Yeah. I can't believe I just filmed the rest of this video in this awkward angle, but I'm gonna close it off up here again. So yeah, if you've made it all the way to the end of this video, you'll see more. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Also, don't forget to follow my other socials to keep up with me outside of YouTube. That's it. Thanks for watching. See y'all in the next video. Bye. Thing your favorite bad bitch turned the whole world into a savage middle finger. All of my bitches just to remind y'all I ain't having it.